Hello guys, happy Thursday. I hope you've been enjoying your week. I wanted to say something I realized I didn't say yesterday in the class about why I focus a lot in these classes on doing like improv emotion type exercises is because in real life we don't plan our emotions. We don't plan how we're going to feel. Our feelings are a reaction to somebody's behavior. We react. Somebody tells us something, we react. Somebody does something, we react, right? We're told we have to stay at home and for months and we're not able to go outside. We have a reaction. So our emotions are always a reaction to someone's behavior, whether we saw something, whether we're told something, whether we hear or see something, emotions are really a reaction to someone's behavior. So I like to do, and we don't plan it, so I love doing lots of exercises where we're just working on being truthful and an imaginary circumstance. I'm reacting to behavior. So that's what we're going to continue to work on today. We're going to do a warm-up. Guys, please continue to send me your songs you want to hear during the warm-up. Okay? Because I always want to play songs I like. I want to play songs you like. Alright, so we're going to do some energy ball work today. Okay, so, hit the energy ball. I'm feeling it in your right hand. Good. Let it go through to your left hand. And both hands. Get your body up. Your arm down. And up. And down. Here, right, goes across. And back. You can do your energy get to your left. And back. And bring your arms up. And take your arms back. The energy takes you up. And takes you back. It takes you up. And then come down. The energy goes to the left. And it comes down. And it moves to your belly area. And the energy circles your body to the right. And it circles to the left. And it goes to your right leg. And to your left leg. And all through your body. Feel the energy, you're energized. Feel that energy. Go to the right. Energy takes you to the left. And you get you forward. And then you bring you up. And the energy is in your leg. And then you're left. And you're right. And you're left. And you're right. Feel the energy. Feel the energy. Let that energy just go through your body. Freestyle. style. Good. Let's let this slow you down. And slow. Good, guys. Let's take a few deep breaths. We'll do some more breathing focus work tomorrow. But for now, take a few deep breaths. Good. So today we're going to work on responding in the moment. So I'm going to give you a character and an imaginary circumstance. You're going to respond in the moment using improv to what you're going to hear. So for example, say the person you're playing a teacher, right? Alright, you're playing a teacher. You stepped out of your classroom to talk to the principal, and your kids are taking a test. When you come back in, they're having a paper, wadding out paper, they're having a paper ball fight, and everything's a mess. Total chaos, right? So you're a teacher, you just stepped out of your classroom to talk to the principal, your students were quiet taking a test. When you step back in, there's chaos, they're throwing papers, it's just a mess. How would you react to that, teacher? What would you say? React in the moment and action. So what are you telling the kids, right? You're reacting in the moment and action. Good, guys. So again, I'm going to give you a circumstance, give you a character, I'm going to tell you what happens, you're going to react in the moment, okay? You're a mechanic, right? So you work, you fix cars, okay? You come out of your office, and there's a customer there. You go to greet him, and you realize the customer is Oscar winner, two-time Oscar winner, Denzel Washington. You know that if you do right by him, this could change your business. How are you going to respond? What are you going to say? Denzel Washington wants to fix his car. React. That's your imaginary circumstance. You're a mechanic. You just came out of your office. There's a new customer wanted to fix the car. Denzel Washington. How do you react? What do you say? Respond in the moment. Good guys, and shake that off. Oh, guys, I always try to remember to shake it off. Sometimes I don't say that, but I always try to remember. Good. Let's do another one. You're a hairstylist, okay? Or a barber, hairstylist. So you just colored somebody's hair. They wanted the hair to be colored blonde, okay? So you're just done with the coloring and taking out the cap. You just colored their hair. It's your number one customer. It's her wedding day. The Tomorrow is her wedding day. You did her hair. You did this bandana. And when you take off her cap, you see her hair is bright blue. She did not want her hair to be bright blue. There's nothing wrong with having blue hair. Blue hair is beautiful. But your customer did not want blue hair. She wanted blonde hair. So, how would you tell her? How are you going to respond in the moment and tell her that her hair is blue when she wanted it blonde? How are you feeling? What are you going to say? Something not going to be very happy. How are you going to respond in the moment? Good. And again, guys, let me say there's nothing wrong with having blue hair. Blue hair is beautiful. It's just that this particular customer did not want blue hair. So you're responding to this customer. But again, nothing wrong with blue hair, okay? That's not what I was saying. You're just responding in this particular moment. Okay? Good. Let's go on to another one. Okay, you're an inventor, okay? You and your partner invented this brand new invention that makes coffee in 30 seconds. That's your invention. You made a coffee machine that can make coffee in 30 seconds. The brand new invention. Okay, right? You go to a conference or to talk about your brand new invention that you and your partner worked on together, and your partner takes all the credit. He takes all the credit for something you worked on together, so now you're alone in the room. What would you say to your partner? You just stole and took credit for all the things you did together, and he took all the credit. All right, what would you say in the moment if you're that inventor? Good. Imagine the hurt. You got betrayed. What would you say? Be specific. Your partner took credit for inventing you two made together. What is your response in that circumstance? Be specific and let your partner know how you feel. Imagine, see him right in front of you. Talk to him. Good. Good, okay. Let's do one more, guys. One more. Alright? You're a farmer. Right? You're going to play. Yeah, again. This one here. Good, okay. So, you're playing a farmer. Alright? A farmer. And you realize there was a bad storm. And all your crops are ruined for the entire year. They're ruined. All the crops, you know, farmers, they grow corn, they grow vegetables to bring, then people come and buy the vegetables. But your whole crop is ruined. There was a businessman who was going to buy all your crops for his store, and now you have nothing for him to buy. So you need to tell him that you have nothing for him. That all your crops are ruined. You're on the phone. That you call this businessman and we're going to buy all your crops for his store and tell him you have nothing to give him. All your crops are ruined. What What would you say? How would you feel? Okay, good. 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 And then do one more. All right. Okay. You are an electrician, okay? An electrician. You just rewired. You did a job for your sister. You rewired her whole house. She's moving into a new house. You rewired the whole house. And now she doesn't think she has to pay you. Okay. She thinks you're gonna do it. She thought that you would do it for free. And you may give her a discount, but you weren't gonna do it for free. So let her know how you feel, because she, your sister, after you did all that work of the electrician to rewire and fit the house, she's not gonna pay you now. So she's not gonna pay you. What would you say to her? How would that make you feel? Another imaginary circumstance. Tell your sister, talk to your sister, let her know how you feel. This is the imaginary circumstance. Your sister is not paying you for a job you did. Okay, good. Good guys, okay, shake that out, good. Shake that out, we just did a lot of emotional work today. Shake all that off. All right, we'll be back tomorrow on Friday. We're always back with Shakespeare Insults. So I'll see you tomorrow, guys. I love you, I miss you. I cannot wait till we're all together again. Have a beautiful, beautiful rest of the day. See you tomorrow, bye-bye.